Okay, viewers, today we are going to look at what is glycolysis, but we are going to base on what the mechanism of body of an arsenic poisoning. But for today, I'm going to demonstrate only from the point when fructose 1.6 bisphosphate. Fructose 1.6 bisphosphate and aldolase enzyme what split into three carbon sugars, deoxyacetone phosphate and glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate. And after the equilibration of what between the hydroxine as a tone phosphate. Deoxyacetone phosphate with the glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate 3 phosphate equilibration which takes place in presence of the enzyme known as the triose phosphate isomerase. Starting from this point, as usual, because what the deoxyacetone phosphate is a kind of what of a ketone, and the glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate is what is kind of what of an aldehyde. Therefore, this ketone has high resistance to oxidation, so we must put in isomerize it into glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate. After isomerization, in both parts, we are going to have what is glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate. This is going to be what is vanished. So, but I'm going to deal with only one side. This side of what is glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate to demonstrate how arsenic can lead into interaction of what of glycolysis. How arsenic may result into the energy deficiency, not in the glycolysis process. We know clearly that at this point inorganic phosphate is actually what is produced towards what glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate, and at the same time what we know exactly that what NAD positive forms what NADH, which is kind of what of an oxidation to form 1.3 bisphosphone. Glycerate, where this inorganic phosphate is going to fix at what the first position after oxidation of what glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate to form what carboxylate, which is what is a type of this one. Under the enzyme here we know known as what glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate. Then from this point we actually extract 1 AGP, one inorganic phosphate from what 1.3 bisphosphate glycerate to form an ATP with adenosine what triphosphate from this what stage, which is kind of what is kind of what substrate level phosphorylation, and then at every stage actually times by 2, even times 2. At this stage, under influence of enzyme known as what phosphoglycerate kinase, under the influence of what of this kind of enzyme known as what phosphoglycerate kinase, one inorganic phosphate is going to be removed from what 1.3 bisphosphate to form what 3 phosphoglycerate. Glycerate from what 3 phosphoglycerate from what 3 phosphoglycerate from 3-phosphoglycerate again, Even here, it's times 2. From 1 to 3, phosphoglycerate. Again, from 1 to 3, phosphoglycerate. Under the influence of water, of another kind of water, we have engineer known as what in phosphoglycerate. Phosphoglycerate. You are going to transform 3 phosphoglycerates into 2 phosphoglycerates. 2 phosphoglycerate. We transform 3 phosphoglycerates into 2 phosphoglycerates. And the presence of methyl non-resulting phosphoglycerate mutase, we transform the phosphate from what the third position to towards the second position. And then the next stage, in that stage, where we are going to form what phosphoenol, pyruvate, phosphoenol pyruvate. Here in presence of benzene known as enolase. In presence of water benzene known as enolase, where water molecule is going to be open. We extract water molecule from what from two phosphoglycerate to form phosphoenopyruvate. Then from what phosphoenopyruvate, we go directly. In presence again of what enzyme here known as what pyruvate kinase to form what a pyruvate here, to form what a pyruvate. Again, an ADP is going to be phosphorylated to form what an ATP. But remember, at each stage, we might try by two. What the meaning of this? Here we have obtained two ATPs now. So long as it's times two, here two ATPs plus even here, two ATPs. So total ATPs which are going to be formed. Total ATPs which are going to be formed through what? Glycolysis stage are the four ATPs. One ATP is from what this stage? While we extract 21 inorganic phosphate from what 1.3 bisphosphate to form 3 phosphoglycerate, another GP is where what phosphoenopyruvate, we extract phosphate group from what phosphoenopyruvate to form pyruvate under influence of what pyruvate kinase, under influence of what pyruvate kinase. So these total ATPs actually we minus 2 ATPs from what from the state of what phosphorylation of water of sugar, or from what the state of what investment stage, from what investment stage or phosphorylation of sugar. So net gain of what of ATP, net gain of ATP is equal to 2 ATP. The whole mechanism of what of glycolysis actually provides only 2 ATP, provides only what 2 ATPs. So from this point, Let us now look the mechanism of arsenic poisoning. The mechanism of what of arsenic poisoning. Arsenic is kind of what of a heavy metal. Arsenic is kind of what of a heavy metal. Arsenic, especially the pentavalent of what of arsenic. Pentavalent of what arsenic, non-evoting arsenate. Compete with inorganic phosphate at active site of these enzymes, glycerol 3 what phosphate dehydrogenase. Instead of what inorganic phosphate to fix at these what enzymes. Instead of what inorganic phosphate to fix at the active site of what glycerol 3 phosphate dehydrogenase, this inorganic phosphate is going to be repaired mostly when there is what a large number or there is a high concentration of what arsenate, pentavalent arsenate will going to attack the active site where this inorganic phosphate usually used to be attacked. So by attacking this one, the serrated 3-phosphate dehydrogenase enzyme will result in the formation of a very complex compounds known as arsenate glycerated 3-phosphate dehydrogenase complex. This kind of complex will inhibit this stage, formation of this stage up to this stage. All this stage will be inhibited. The stage of oxidation and addition of inorganic phosphates toward glycerated 3-phosphate will be inhibited. And the result is going to be the formation of a complex known as arsenate glycerated 3-phosphate dehydrogenase complex. This kind of complex known as arsenate glycerated 3-phosphate dehydrogenase will be hydrolyzed directly to the 3-phosphoglycerate, toward 3-phosphoglycerate without passing these stages. The meaning of bypassing this stage or escaping this stage, it means that there will be no production. There will be no production of an ATP here. And so long as the process is twice, it means that here we are not going to form 4 ATPs. We are not going to form 4 ATPs. We are going to form only 2 ATPs from this stage. The stage of phosphoenolpyruvate transformation of phosphoenolpyruvate to pyruvate, where phosphorylation takes place, where inorganic phosphate from phosphoenolpyruvate is going to be fixed here to form an ATP. So if you take only 2 ATPs under this condition, it means that 2 ATPs, all the 2 ATPs from glycolysis will be subtracted with 2 ATPs from investment state. So the net gain of ATP is going to be zero. So no net energy will be produced during glycolysis because of the presence of this heavy metal known as arsenic. So arsenic prevents this stage of converting glycerated 3-phosphate to 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate, then 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate from 3-phosphate glycerate. Instead, once arsenate, the pentavalent arsenate combined with this glycerated 3-phosphate dehydrogenase to form a complex. The complex will be hydrolyzed directly through 3-phosphoglycerate. And escaping this stage, escapement of this stage may result in energy deficiency, because only 2 ATPs is going to obtain over there. If you take only 2 ATPs from glycolysis, then those 2 ATPs must subtract with 2 ATPs from investment state, the result which is going to be zero. So this kind of mechanism is an energy deficiency mechanism. What is kind of energy deficiency mechanisms? Once we employ arsenic within our cell, especially once blocks this glycolytic pathway, it results in energy deficiency in most of anaerobic cells. In most anaerobic cells, not only that, even at pyruvate dehydrogenase, because pyruvate dehydrogenase depends on lipoic acid, which is kind of cofactor, also has the tendency of this acidic has the tendency of breaking down the procedures of from pyruvate to form acetyl CoA. Thank you for listening.